Well, good evening, Grace Brethren. Welcome. My name is Matt Cooper. I have the privilege of serving as the principal of Grace Brethren Elementary. Welcome to our first ever virtual Christmas concert, preschool through 12th grade. We are so glad that you can join us and enjoy this evening of being able to worship the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
I've got this Christmas song in my song. tree. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my song. The love that Christmas can bring. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me.
Hi, everyone. My name is Pastor Tim Howard. I have the distinct privilege of serving as chaplain for our Grace Brethren schools, all the way from preschool through high school. It's an honor for me to be able to work with your students in all those age categories and to be here today to explain a little about what you're going to see. Our students have been learning the Beatitudes. That's the salutation to the Sermon on the Mount. That's where what Jesus starts with as he begins the greatest sermon ever preached by the greatest preacher. The Word tells us that he went through Galilee teaching in synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom. Jesus was crowding out the synagogues. He moved outside to where everyone could hear him. Not just the men, but the men, the women, the children, the disenfranchised. And he begins his sermon with a portion that we call the Beatitudes. And he talks about the things that are really internal. Our students are learning this to music. God's Word tells us in Psalm 119:11, if we hide God's Word in our heart, we won't sin against Him. So our students have been learning this. But what they've been learning is, this is the manifesto of Jesus as he starts his ministry on earth here. And it's an amazing thing. It's internal. He says, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn, those who are meek. If you were starting a movement, you wouldn't necessarily start with those things. The world would say, no, that's foolishness. But Jesus isn't looking for the outward. He's looking for the inward. Because it's our thoughts and our thinking that changes our attitudes and our actions. See, Jesus isn't preaching a prosperity gospel here. He's preaching a gospel of truth and hope. His kingdom is not of this earth. It's one to come. People wanted to make him a leader, a politician, but no, he came to be a servant. He came to give his life, a ransom for many. What your students learn as they're going through the process of learning this music and being involved in almost every aspect of our school is they're learning a biblical worldview. They're learning that the gospel of Jesus Christ is what gives hope. That's the only hope that mankind has in spite of all that's going on around us. As you begin or are in the middle of a Christmas season here, I pray that the words and the music of our students really blesses you, really gives you a hope that is substantial, a hope in, again, the gospel of Jesus Christ, the only hope that we have. Have a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. I will be playing Sleigh Ride.
That was recording, right?
Coming to you live today from Grace Brethren School's breaking news.
2020 is a year for the record books. It's now officially the busiest hurricane season ever, and more storms could be on the way.
Growing urgency across the country as new coronavirus cases reach levels never before seen.
Here in Los Angeles, a disturbing scene when dozens of people moved onto the 101 freeway. And
Psalm 46, verses 1 through 3. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. Selah.
Tonight in Los Angeles, a local emergency as 6 new coronavirus cases have been confirmed and now a startling warning shaking the region of 10 million people. Growing concern, the virus could quickly impact vulnerable homeless populations in cities across the country.
For the travel industry, the coronavirus has been a body blow. Cruise ships quarantined, meetings and conferences called off, corporate travel curtailed, study abroad programs and school trips canceled.
For I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you in my righteous right hand. Isaiah 41:10.
For 2 straight nights, Minneapolis has been wrecked with violent protests. Anger flared up in downtown Los Angeles. Thousands of protesters packed the LA Civic Center last night. The crowd initially peaceful, but soon turning ugly as dozens of them blocked the 101 freeway.
Isaiah 43:2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you.
Overnight, the sprawl of more than 500 California wildfires surged in a relentless march of flames. Hardest hit, the North, where the state's largest fires are churning through wine country, incinerating homes, reducing whole neighborhoods to piles of rubble and ash. So far, the fires have scorched more than 770,000 acres, destroying more than 500 structures, forcing the evacuations of thousands. Meanwhile, firefighters battling back on the front lines are stretched to
Psalm 27:1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
Silent Night was first performed over 200 years ago in Austria. Since that time, thousands of renditions in hundreds of languages have been played and sung. Although the music is iconic to the Christmas season, how many of us enjoy evenings in which all is calm? And forget Christmas season. How many of us enjoy a silent and holy night consistently throughout the year, especially this year? How hard has it been to hear the message that God's Son, love's pure light, has made a way for us to have a relationship with God? Or to see God's glory streaming down from heaven above and blessing us? Instead, many times we have been focused on illness, politics, division, broken relationships, and at times even death. For my family this year, it started in January when my son broke his nose. Soon after that, I caught both strains of the flu, battled pneumonia for 5 months. And then in the midst of that, I had 3 kidney stone operations and 3 neck procedures. Just as about the time I was recovered from pneumonia, my daughter and I contracted COVID-19. And still months later, I struggle at times breathing. In the midst of those things, my dad was diagnosed and treated for stomach cancer. My mom got an infection and has been in the hospital for 9 weeks. And my mother-in-law almost died because of blood clots in her lungs, let alone the fact that my other son broke his wrist. It's been a crazy year, and medically, it has been really a challenge in our home. I'll be open with you. At times, these situations made it more difficult to focus on the truth of heavenly peace. Too many times, and for far too long, I allowed the noise of this world to blur my vision so I didn't see Jesus working. I saw our struggles, I saw my sickness, I saw our circumstances, but at times I didn't see my Savior. There were times that I gave into the pressures of life and stopped enjoying the heavenly peace promised to us in Scripture. Philippians 4, 6, and 7 tells us, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." For many, Jesus being the answer and bringing peace sounds all too simplistic. How can Jesus just solve my problems and salve my wounds? It's the same way he did for Mary as she was preparing to give birth to Jesus, one step at a time through faith. The road may not be easy and the path may not be smooth, but Jesus promised to walk with us. Mary relied on God's provision and care, just as we do 2,000 years later. In Matthew 11, Jesus told his followers, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." And how can he promise that? Well, it's because Jesus is God. He knows our hurts, he knows our tears, he knows our joys, and he knows our true needs. Thankfully, he not only knows our circumstances, but he is willing and able to take care of our circumstances and walk us and sustain us through them. I'm looking forward to finishing my recovery and returning to Grace Brethren. Not just because it's a great school where I can co-labor with my friends and I can see students flourish, but because Grace is a school where our community does not walk alone. God walks with us. We are friends and family who share the love of God and the love of his Son, love's pure light. with those around us. And in our difficulties of life, God allows us to celebrate and to enjoy Him. As you enjoy the Christmas season, I pray that you will enjoy joy and energy and peace and love through the breath of God's love. Merry Christmas.
Help me be strong. Help me be. Help. to them. Fear not, for all the people.
The angel said to them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good news for all the people.
The angel came to a star in the sky, and the lepers were scared of the angel. And then the shepherd went to the baby, and they went to the people.
The star was a big bright sign, and the three kings saw it, and they went to the king. There can't be a new king. I'm the king. Then they went to the king and they gave him presents. Golden presents, silver presents, and I think they gave him chocolate too.
And then Mary and Joseph had to travel on what?
A donkey.
All the way to?
Bethlehem.
And when they got there, was there room?
No.
No, they said?
No.
And then they had to go and give birth to baby Jesus where?
In a barn.
What was in the barn?
Cows, sheep, pigs, and chickens, and bulls.
And then they gave birth to baby Jesus and they put him in a?
Manger.
And then in the sky there was a bright what?
Star.
And who saw the star? Who was watching the sheep?
The boy's name again.
Joseph.
Donkeys and chickens and bolts. I don't like bolts. Bolts are too scary for me. And the hotels were all filled, and the rooms were all filled. They had to sleep, and people were all sleeping on the floor. They had to sleep in a stapler.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, Isaiah 9:6.
God gave his only son, John 3:16.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those who he well pleased.
Can you tell me the story about Christmas?
Yes. A boy angel came, and it said, "Don't be afraid. I'm going to let you have a baby that is going to be a king, and And it's going to be born, and you had to go on a long trip so you can and when you're going back to that land, Bethlehem, and then it will be born in that type of like
place.
One solitary life. He was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up in another obscure village where he worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never went to college. He never visited a big city. He never traveled more than 200 miles from the place where he was born. He did none of the things usually associated with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was only 33. His friends ran away. One of them denied him. He was turned over to his enemies and went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. While dying, his executioners gambled for his clothing, the only property he had on earth. When he was dead, he was laid in a burrowed grave through the pity of a friend. 19 centuries have come and gone, and today Jesus is the central figure of the human race and the leader of mankind's progress. All the armies that have ever marched, all the navies that have ever sailed, all the parliaments that have ever sat, all the kings that have ever reigned put together, have not affected the life of mankind on earth as powerfully as that one solitary life.
Jesus Christ is born. Well,
So this is how it was, a silent night like any other. When heaven sent the one that we would call our Savior.
At redemption began, in the same hope, in Bethlehem.
Well, on behalf of our entire Grace family, our church and our school, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for taking this time to celebrate our Savior and His birth together. Every Christmas time, it's a wonderful time of celebration and joy and hope. And so everyone is special, but I think this year we've all recognized that because it's been so hard, because things have been so uncertain, this Christmas time is a little extra special. It's a great reminder for us. It's a reminder for us that in a time when we're not sure what tomorrow's gonna bring, that Jesus, the Bible says, is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We're also reminded that humanity isn't the hope for humanity. We've seen that it's not in our government officials, it's not even in our scientists that we can trust for hope moving forward. But Christmas reminds us that we absolutely have hope in the person and the work of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Jesus, who is God, very God, who came down at Christmas time to be born into humanity, that he lived a life we could never live. He died a death we deserved so that we have a hope of a resurrection to come. See, Jesus is the solution to our greatest problem, is that he's the salvation that we've been longing for our sinful condition. It's because of that hope that we rejoice at Christmas time. It's for that reason that it is my joy to extend to you from our entire Grace family a very Merry Christmas.